Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the don't care conditions in the digital circuits. Now so far in our discussion, the Boolean functions which we have discussed were actually the completely specified functions. That means for such functions, the output is equal to 1 for the certain input combinations, while for the remaining input combinations, the output is equal to 0. Or in other words, for all input combinations, the output is well defined and it is equal to either 0 or 1. But in practice, in some applications, the function is not specified for the certain input combinations. For example, in the 8421 BCD code, these 6 combinations are the unspecified and these 6 codes are the invalid codes. So the output for these combinations could be either 0 or 1. But since they are the invalid codes, so we actually don't care what is the output for these combinations. So such input combinations for which the output is unspecified are called the don't care combinations. And they can be used in the K-map for the simplification of the Boolean function. Now since the output is not specified for these don't care combinations, so in the K-map, these don't care combinations are defined by the symbol X or D. And during the minimization, it can be considered as either 0 or 1. So while we are finding the minimal expression in the sum of product form, then these don't care terms can be considered as 1. And similarly, when we are finding the minimal expression in the product of sum form, then these don't care conditions can be considered as 0. So depending on our conveniency, we can treat these don't care terms as either 0 or 1. So let us take few examples so that it will get clear to you. So let's say this function f1 is the function of 3 variables. And let's say we want to find the minimal expression in the SOP form. So this function is 1 for the mean terms m0, m1, m3 and m5. And these two mean terms are the don't cares. So first of all, let us represent this function in the K-map. So these mean terms m0, m1, m3 and m5 are represented by 1 in the K-map, while these two don't care mean terms are represented with x. So during the minimization, we should cover all the 1s in the K-map. But during the minimization, we can use these don't care terms for the further simplification. So the usage of this don't care term is optional, but using the don't care terms, if we are finding the further simplification of the Boolean function, then we should use these don't care terms. So first of all, let us find the minimal solution without using the don't care terms. And then after, I will show you that using the don't care terms, we can further simplify this Boolean expression. So without the don't care condition, we can make the group of these m0 and m1. And similarly, we can make the group of this m1 and m3. And likewise, we can also make the group of these m1 and m5. So this group in the blue color corresponds to a bar dot b bar, while this group in the yellow color corresponds to a bar dot c. Because in this group, the value of variable a is equal to 0, while the value of variable c is equal to 1. Similarly, this last group corresponds to b bar dot c. So without using the don't cares, if we see the minimized function, then that is equal to a bar dot b bar plus a bar dot c plus b bar dot c. But in this case, using the don't care terms, we can further simplify the Boolean expression. So if we use this don't care mean term m2 and consider it as a 1, then we can make the group of these 4 ones. Similarly, using the don't care mean term m4, we can make the group of these 4 ones. And in this way, by making only 2 groups, we are able to cover all the ones. So this group corresponds to B bar, while this group in the yellow color corresponds to A bar. And if you see the overall minimized function, then that is equal to A bar plus B bar. So in this way, using the don't care terms, we can further simplify the Boolean expression. So let us take a couple of more examples. So this function f2 is the function of 4 variables. And here, the mean term m1, m7 and m14 are the don't cares. So first of all, let us represent this function in the K-map. And first, let us write down all the mean terms, which is equal to 1. And then, let us represent this don't care mean terms with the x. So here, using the don't care mean term m1, we can make the group of these 4 ones. Similarly, using the don't care mean terms m7 and m14, we can make the group of these 4 ones. And using these two groups alone, we are able to cover all the ones in the K map. So here, this group in the blue color corresponds to C bar dot D, while this group in the yellow color corresponds to B dot C. And if we see the overall minimized function, then it is the summation of the C bar dot D and the B dot C. So in this way, using the don't care terms, we can further simplify the Boolean expression. Now, so far during the minimization, we wanted the minimal solution in the sum of product form. And that is why these don't care terms were considered as one during the minimization. But suppose if we want the minimal solution in the POS form, then we can treat these don't care terms as zero. So let's say, for the same Boolean function, we want to find the minimal solution in the POS form. So for that, first of all, let us mark the remaining cells in the K map with the 0. So these cells, which is marked as 0, represents the max terms. And during the minimization in the POS form, we will only use these max terms. And if you see these don't care terms, then it will remain as it is. So if you see the same function f2 in the product of sum form, then this is how it can be represented. So as you can see, this product of sum form contains all the cells which is marked as 0, and these don't care terms will remain as it is. So now, let us try to minimize the same function in the POS form. And for that, whenever it is required, we will consider these don't care terms as 0. So in this case, as you can see, we can make the group of these 4 zeros. Similarly, we can also make the group of these mean term m2 and m3 and this m10 and m11. So in this way, by making these two groups, we are able to cover all the zeros in the K map. So this group corresponds to C bar dot D bar, while this group corresponds to B bar dot C. That means this function f2 dash is the summation of this B bar dot C and the C bar dot D bar. And the function f2 is the complement of the f2 dash. So using the De Morgan's law, we can say that this f2 is equal to D plus C bar dot C plus D. So that is the minimal expression in the POS form. So in this way, even if the function is given to us in the sum of product form, then also we can find the minimal solution in the POS form. And during the minimization, we can treat these don't care terms as zero. So of course, in this case, there was no need to use the don't care terms, but in general, if required, then these don't care terms can be used during the minimization. So let us take another example. So in this third example, this function f3 is given in the POS form. So first of all, let us represent this function in the K map. And first, let us represent all the max terms with the 0 in the K map. And now, let us represent this don't care terms with the x. So here during the minimization in the POS form, we can consider all these don't care terms as 0. So as you can see, here we can make the group of these 4 zeros and these 4 zeros. And using the don't care max term m2, we can make the group of these 4 zeros. So now, all the zeros in the map gets covered. So this group in the blue color corresponds to C dot D, while this group in the pink color corresponds to B bar dot D bar. And likewise, this last group corresponds to A dot B bar. So here, since all the groups are the groups of zeros, so we can say that this function f3 dash is equal to A dot B bar plus B bar dot D bar plus C dot D. And by taking the complement of it, we will get the function f3. So using the De Morgan's law, we can say that this function f3 is equal to A bar plus B dot B plus D dot C bar plus D bar. So that is how, using the don't care condition, we can find the minimal expression in the POS form. Now for the same function, let us see how to find the minimal expression in the SOP form. So to find the minimal expression in the SOP form, we will consider all the ones in the K map. So first of all, let us mark the remaining cells with the one in the K map. And for the SOP form, let us ignore all the zeros. And at the same time, we will keep all the don't care terms as it is. So the same function in the SOP form can be written like this. So now, let us try to minimize it. So here, using this don't care min term M4, we can make the group of these four ones and these four ones. And to cover the min term M1, we can make the group of these two ones. So in this way, by making the three groups, we are able to cover all the ones in the K map. So here, this group corresponds to B dot D bar, while this group in the yellow color corresponds to B dot C bar. And likewise, this group in the blue color corresponds to A bar dot C bar dot D. So if you see the minimal expression in the SOP form, then it is the summation of all these groups. So in this way, for the given Boolean function, we can find the minimal expression in the SOP form as well as the POS form. So I hope in this video, you understood what is don't care condition and how we can use the don't care terms for finding the minimal solution of the given function. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.